PLDs.
We will be going through PLDs first. So what are PLDs? Programmable
Logic Devices.
Basically what happens when you go through your previous semesters, you must have learned about equations, you know, Boolean algebra, like, okay? You must have got some equations either in terms of SOPs or in terms of POS. SOPs means
sum of
product. POS means product of sums. Okay. If you write an equation, you can write down the equations. If suppose we have to write the equations, the equation could be like this. So this we call it as sum of product. This we call it as sum of product. And if you want to realize this equation by using gates, then first you require AND gate and then the OR gate. So AND gate, these three things, these three inputs, this gate will be having these three inputs. This AND gate will be having A, B bar, C. So what happens here? A, B, C, A, B bar, C, first standard here. Two products and then those products have been summed here. That is why we call it as sum of product. So in PLDs, we can realize sum of products. In PLDs, we can realize sum of products. Okay. So every PLD will be consisting of two things. What? Array, two array it will have. One will be the AND array or dusri wali array will be the OR array. We will have AND array and a OR array. So if I tell you what are PLDs, programmable logic devices, which can be used to realize a combinational circuit. Because you can see that such kind of equations we mention in combinational circuits. Okay. If it is a sequential circuit, then we must have to have a flip-flop there. Okay. The feedback kind of thing are there in sequential circuit, but this is a combinational circuit. So in this combinational, this is a combinational circuit. And this combinational circuits can be realized by using PLDs. So what PLDs we are going to learn are the PLDs which are used to realize SOPs. SOPs. Okay. Sum of product form. And the PLD will be having AND array and OR array. The size of a PLD is defined depending on the size of these arrays. So if you talk about how big is a PLD, how simple is a PLD, how complex is a PLD, it depends on these two things. Okay, one is an AND array and another one is a OR array. So the PLDs definitely will be having their AND array. So if I am here drawing a PLD which can have two inputs, let me call the inputs as A and B. Okay, I will be having here a combination of A, B, only two input, 2-bit PLD we are taking example here. Okay, then this will be A bar and this will be B bar. So the normal practice in PLD or digital design is we should have a lower bit on this side and a higher bit on this side. Most significant bit on this side, least significant bit on. So in future if you wanted to add C, we can add it here itself. We need not to modify the diagram that way. So we are having a practice of writing LSB first, then MSB. So A we considering as a lower significant bit, we have written it as first. So this will be A bar, this will be A, this will be B bar, and this will be B. So this AND gate will be connected to any two of the input from this four, A bar, B, B bar. Similarly, this AND gate. So every AND gate will be connected to any two of the inputs, any two format of the inputs, either A bar, B bar, like that. Okay, and then these things has been connected to a OR gate. Let us consider that in our PLD we have a OR array of two gates. Here the AND array is of four gates. So for two inputs, we should have a AND array of four gates. So the relation is 2 raised to 2, like this. So if the bit is B size, then the array will be 2 raised to B size. The array should be 2 raised to B size. So this is AND array. So OR array we are considering of 2 OR array, and the inputs to the OR array will be from this side. It will be from this side. Okay. Inputs to the OR array will be from this side. Now, PLDs are programmable. PLDs are programmable. We have three type of PLDs. The PLDs, programmable logic devices, are of three types. We'll have one as PROM, another one as PAL, third one as PLA. So PROM is a very well known term to all of you, programmable read only memory, which can be programmed. Okay, which can be programmed. How do you exactly program a PROM? So it consists of fuses. Actually speaking, the earlier time when the PROMs were introduced, it consists of fuses, and you used to give a very high voltage to that so that the fuse get blow off. Wahan pe fuse rehta tha. और तुम हाई वोल्टेज देकर के वो फ्यूज को ब्लो ऑफ करते थे या रहने देते थे, उसके हिसाब से कनेक्शन या तो रहता था या तो नहीं रहता था. तो जीरो और वन रहता था या नहीं रहता था, जीरो और वन इस तरीके से तुम रख सकते थे. दिस वाज अ केस. अब कैसा हुआ, जब मैंने बोला यहाँ पे PROM, तो प्रोग्रामेबल रीड ओनली मेमोरी. दूसरा क्या बोला, PAL, प्रोग्रामेबल अरे लॉजिक, प्रोग्रामेबल लॉजिक अरे. तो नाम वही है हा? लेकिन इनके फिर भी तीन टाइप क्यों बताया गया, तो वो समझने के लिए वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस आर्किटेक्चर. वी हैव अ AND array, दैट इज व्हाट वी सेड, दिस इज अ AND array एंड दिस इज अ OR array. तो वी हैव टू अरेज हियर, वी कॉल इट एज AND array एंड OR array. सो if you consider this AND array and OR array, and you consider the thing is it programmable or not programmable? Okay, since we are talking about a logic devices whose name itself is a programmable logic device, we have two arrays, AND array and OR array. So these arrays can be programmable, these arrays can be programmable. So abhi kaun si array is programmable, we'll say that ये वाली प्रोग्रामेबल है कि ये वाली प्रोग्रामेबल है, कि दोनों प्रोग्रामेबल है, कि दोनों प्रोग्रामेबल नहीं है. अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट दे हैज बीन क्लासिफाइड इन दिस थ्री टर्म्स. सो द फर्स्ट कंसीडर द केस व्हेन बोथ ऑफ देम आर नॉट प्रोग्रामेबल. सो इफ दे आर नॉट प्रोग्रामेबल, दिस डिवाइस कैन नॉट बी कॉल्ड एज अ प्रोग्रामेबल लॉजिक डिवाइस. यू कैन नॉट कॉल दैट डिवाइस एज अ प्रोग्रामेबल लॉजिक डिवाइस. सो आइदर one should be programmable. If I say that this is programmable, this is non-programmable. The another combination could be this is not programmable and this is programmable. And the last one could be both of them could be programmable. Both of them could be programmable, isn't it? So when I say that non-programmable, non-programmable, this things does not exist in our case. This thing does not exist in our case. I'll just change the nomenclature here to mix with that. I'll say that non-programmable, then programmable, then non-programmable and programmable. I'll have this as non-programmable, non-programmable, programmable and programmable. This is generally we write bits, hai na?
0 0 0 1 0 1 1 like that, no? So I am writing it the same way: non-programmable, programmable, non-programmable, programmable, non-programmable, non-programmable, programmable and programmable. So the first case does not occur. तो नॉन पीएलडी, तो वो पीएलडी में आएगी नहीं, दोनों प्रोग्रामेबल नहीं है तो आएगी नहीं केस. अब अगर ये केस लेते हैं अपन कि जहां पे एंड अरे नॉन प्रोग्रामेबल है और अरे प्रोग्रामेबल है, और अरे प्रोग्रामेबल है, तो दैट डिवाइस वी कॉल इट एज प्रॉम. दैट डिवाइस वी कॉल इट एज प्रॉम. वो डिवाइस को अपन क्या बोलते हैं? PROM, प्रॉम, प्रोग्रामेबल रीड ओनली मेमोरी. वो डिवाइस जहां पे एंड अरे प्रोग्रामेबल है और अरे नॉट प्रोग्रामेबल है. एंड अरे इज प्रोग्रामेबल, दिस इज फिक्स्ड, दिस इज नॉन प्रोग्रामेबल. दैट डिवाइस वी कॉल इट एज प्रोग्रामेबल अरे लॉजिक, PAL, प्रोग्रामेबल अरे लॉजिक. द लास्ट डिवाइस वी कॉल इट एज PLA, प्रोग्रामेबल लॉजिक अरे. ओके, व्हेन बोथ ऑफ देम आर प्रोग्रामेबल, व्हेन बोथ ऑफ देम आर प्रोग्रामेबल. गॉट इट? सो दिस इज about the programmable and non-programmable properties of PLAs. If you want to compare the PLDs, so you can have three type: PROM, PAL and PAL. Okay, these are the three types. Programmable logic devices can be used to realize a combinational circuit. They can be used to realize a combinational circuit, isn't it? Understood? So programmable logic devices are used to realize a SOP, sum of product, a combinational form, sum of product. They will be having AND array and a OR array. They will be having AND array and a OR array. So here we have considered an example of a two input, two output PLD. Two input A and B, two output, we call it as Y1, Y2. Two input, two output PLD. So in this, we will be in a AND array combination and a OR array combination. The output of AND will be connected to the inputs of a OR gate. So after that, we have seen that PLDs can be classified as PROM, PAL and PLA. PROM means programmable read-only memory. PAL means programmable array logic, programmable logic array. These are the three classifications. Then we have either a both of them, the gates, we have compared that AND array and OR array. We are having AND array and OR array. So we have seen that which array is programmable. According to that, the classification exists. When we say that both are non-programmable, this case does not exist in PLDs. This case does not exist in PLDs. So if this is programmable, AND array is non-programmable, OR array is programmable, that falls under PROM category. When this is programmable, non-programmable, PAL, and when both are programmable, PLA. This is revision of the portion. Got it? Understood this?